So let's get started with understanding what exactly an ERP system is. So in the traditional system, people used to rely on multiple softwares in order to go ahead and perform various actions. So whenever there's an organization, there is sales involved. And if there's sales involved, that means there's production that is coming behind the scenes. There are logistics that need to be handled. And of course, there is billing as well. So marketing could also be one of the aspects. So if I had to talk about the traditional system, all these were handled by individual software. So if you received an order, it always starts with an order. So if you receive an order, then the system would go ahead and refer to softwares which would take care of all these various individual components, starting from probably sales. So there are lots of sales oriented software that are available. There are separate CRMs that are available, which will allow you to, you know, make sure that you are able to go ahead and properly manage all your customer relationship details. There are softwares which are specifically focusing only on the production components. So how much data you have, or how much how many components you have in house, how many do you have in hand, what is the order that is received, how much do you have to go ahead with the production in that case, all of that would be calculated by using such production softwares. For logistics, you would have a separate software. So in this case, what's happening is you are relying on multiple softwares in order to just perform or bring into one system inside the organization. The problem over here was that, first of all, of course, because of the fact that we have multiple softwares involved, we would have to maintain all of them individually. So for you to get the final product, you have to go ahead and make sure you are maintaining all these multiple software in the organization. If there is anything that is upset, if there is anything that you have to go back to the system or the team which has created that software for you, it would be a big process because you, most of the cases, never had control on the development of the software. You were consuming these softwares only as the end user. And that became one of the major reasons where it became very difficult for maintaining them. For every small change, you will have to go back to the team which developed it, and then they would implement the change. And this is how most of the ERP systems, or rather I would say the traditional systems, worked. As a solution to this, we had the ERP into picture. So what happened when enterprise resource planning came into system? All this was handled by just one software, and that is called the ERP software. In an ERP application, you can bring in everything together, not just sales, production, logistics, billing. It started off handling project management, CRM, financial management, HR management, supply chain management. So now what was happening is, instead of buying multiple softwares, which will help you go ahead and handle this individually, you will just have one enterprise resource planning software, which is now going to be taking care of multiple aspects. To start off with, the major aspects that it was handling, or the core aspects for which it was introduced, were project management, customer relationship management, human resource management, supply chain management, and financial management. These were the core areas that were addressed when the ERP system was newly introduced. Then it was not just limited to this, because it was extended to go ahead and handle many, many other areas as well. In fact, Odoo now almost addresses every single area when it comes to management of any of the ERP related components in the organization, right? So it started off with these core areas, and then it also gave you the flexibility to manage them yourself. Let's say you wanted to tweak the CRM a little. Your style of managing the customers is a little different compared to that of what is generic in the market. So in that case, you need not go back to the team in order to go ahead and make that slight editing of the software for you. You had the control on the development part of it, and that is how it became very, very popular. Not all the ERP systems in the market allow you to do that. You will also have to go back to the team in order to make any kind of edit or modification. But Odoo, compared to the other ERP system, lets you do that, and it is also not something that is very complicated, which is what is one of the major reasons that makes it popular. Now, there are multiple reasons for the naming convention that it got. One is, of course, it is an on-demand open object, from where it actually gets its name. But there's also another interesting history how Odoo got its name. So let's understand about the evolution of this particular software. So first of all, there was something called as Tiny ERP. So this is how the software was released initially. And it was around 2005. And it was meant only for the usage by small scale industry. It helped in addressing only these core areas and nothing beyond that. And it could not be used by a huger audience crowd, right? So this was somewhere around 2005. Then when they wanted to expand this, they renamed it as Open ERP. This was around 2010, and it was not just renamed, but it was also upgraded in such a way that it can be used by both small and medium scale industries. Okay, now in Open ERP itself, you had version 5, version 6, version 6.1, there was version 7 also. So that is what was handled in the second phase. The third phase was somewhere around 2014, which was released, and that is where it was called as Odoo. So one major reason that it was named like this is this double O, which they wanted to go ahead and name the software as well as the organization, which was inspired by Google. Google has a double O in it. Yahoo has a double O in it. So somehow it was influenced by that. And of course, the other fact that it is an open demand object, and the fact that they wanted to incorporate a double O is where the name stemmed from. And this is something which can be used for even MNCs and any of the large scale industry. Okay, so from version 8 onwards, all the various versions of Odoo that were introduced were under the same name, under the same manner. Okay. The next part to understand about the plans that you have here, or the costing models that are available. Now, there are two plans that are available when it comes to Odoo. One is the community plan, and the second one is the enterprise one. OK, Okay, so you have the community plan and the enterprise plan. Now, the community plan is free. You don't have to pay anything for it. And in this case, you will get to access only the web client, not the mobile client. That is one of the major difference between the two of them. So here you will get to access only the web client. The mobile version of Odoo is something that you will not be able to access in case you hold only the community plan. So that is something you can do in enterprise. So both the mobile and the web client are accessible. But one thing that we have to remember here is that if you're going with the mobile client at any point of time, you will not be able to edit something over there. If you want to make some changes, the first phase that I was talking about, you know, tweaking or let's say creating a new module altogether, that cannot be done in the mobile client. You need to refer to the web client in order to do that. So mobile client is not editable. Now, when you're using the community version, it is not going to automatically update any version. You have to manually upgrade it, right? So automatic upgrade of version is not available when you're using the community version. But if you're using the enterprise version, you don't have to worry about any software upgradation because it is automatically handled.
Anusha, when it comes to the mobile, so yeah. Any custom modules are not applied to the mobile and the enterprise?
You can consume it as an end user in the enterprise. You can consume the application, but you will not be able to create or edit the application. That would not be allowed. So let's say I create an application for myself called as course management application, because with the fact that I'm taking up multiple courses, I have to manage the courses, let's say manage the courseware, manage the participants taking up the courses. I create one. Now, I would be able to use that application on my mobile on the go, right? But I will not be able to, let's say I want to edit something in that application. When I say edit, I'm not consuming it. I'm going behind the scenes in order to make some change in the UI. That I will not be able to do when I'm using the mobile application. But I can consume it. You know, I can open the application, add a new course, you know, delete a course which I don't want to take up any further, upgrade a course version or something, that I can do. But let's say in the list of courses that I'm showing, I want to hide the price column. I don't want to show that. So this is not something that I can do from the UI. I have to go behind the scenes and I have to make sure that I'm hiding that particular column. So that is something you cannot do in the mobile client. Okay.
So if you create a custom module, would I see it on the mobile view?
Yes, you would.
I would.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Okay.
All right. Now, in that also, you know, there are some modules which would not be, see, custom module are something that you are creating, but you have something called as advanced modules as well. Like, for example, there are some modules which Odoo provides us, like barcode module, there's WhatsApp module. These are advanced modules, right? So if I show you the interface here, these modules which you see right now, like planning, project, surveys, inventory, manufacturing, these are all the basic modules. These modules, you can go ahead and consume them on your web client also, on your mobile client also. But let's say I am creating a new module here in this empty space called as a course management application. Although I created it myself, it's a custom module because of that. I can consume it in the web client also. I can consume it in the mobile client also. But There are also some advanced modules which is provided by Odoo, like WhatsApp. You can see Odoo WhatsApp integration, right? So such advanced modules, you will not be able to consume on the mobile client. Okay.
Is there, are they categorized like these advanced modules where I could say it's advanced module and I cannot use it on the mobile?
You don't have a list as such. Let me see if there's any difference. No, I don't think there is any list as such. Let me see if it is available in open source. Okay, I'll check that and I'll let you know.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. In community version, you will not get them in either of the clients, in either the web or the mobile client, both of them you will not get. Okay.
Okay.
Put it like this, advanced modules are not accessible. Rather saying partially, I'll put it like this, unaccessible. Web client All right, now let's talk about the pricing modules. So now one of the best reasons, or rather I would say one of the major reasons for Odoo gaining so much of popularity is the cost effective pricing module that it provides. So if I had to show you that, you can see here there are three plans or three models that are available. You have one app free, you have standard, and then you have custom. Right. So depending upon your requirement, let's say you want to go with just the trial version, like in this particular course where we are just having an overview of all the applications or modules, we can go just with the free version, free community version. We don't have to pay anything as such. But let's say you want to go with, one user, 1 month, where you are able to go ahead and access all the applications. Right. So you don't want to try with, now we are going to be using the free trial of this particular plan. Right. But eventually what will happen after 15 days, we will lose everything that we are trying out, experimenting over here. If you want to go ahead and retain that, then that's where you will take the standard model. Then you also have a custom plan as well. Now in custom model, what happens is it is most of the features in the custom model is the same as that of the standard plan. But you have one additional option, and that is to host any kind of custom changes when you make the development. So if you are eventually looking forward to incorporate Odoo in the organization, plus also do development into existing modules or create a new module, you have to go with the custom plan. Only then you will be able to go ahead and do the hosting of the changes. So of course, we are going to be doing changes in our side as well, you know, when we are going to be looking at the technical aspect. But after we complete the module, so everything that you're going to be creating on your end, or I'm going to be creating from my end, I would be able to consume it. Your application that you would be creating, only you would be able to consume it. How would you make it available to everybody else in your organization? You will have to host it maybe on-prem server, or maybe, you know, anywhere that you are able to go ahead and share it with the entire internal portal or the organization that you're working for, right? That is where you will require a custom plan. Okay, so there are separate charges which are included. If you click on buy now, it will show you the hosting type. You can go with the standard cloud hosting. If you want to do it yourself, self-hosting, you can choose which is the hosting type that you want. and the implementation service as well. Again, you can see the, you know, based on what you're choosing here. Let's say I go with self-hosting, right? And I want to do it with a local partner. There are a lot of silver partners that are available, which are directly tied up with Odoo, which will help you with, you know, understanding how the implementation works or which one would be the best. These are all the list of partners which are available, gold partners, silver partners, right? So you can choose any of them. And accordingly, you will see the price over here, right? It will give you an estimate of how much would that cost. And this is for just one user. If you still are not very sure, you know, you want to go ahead and negotiate with this, or you want to directly talk to the customer care support, the Odoo software, one good part is that it has a very, very good customer care. They would go ahead and call you back if you drop them a message, and you would be able to talk to them, negotiate the charges that you see the estimation for over here. Again, this is not the final price. You can always go ahead and talk to the customer care of any of the partners or directly with Odoo customer care as well. Okay, but as of now, what we need to understand is that we have three options or three plans, three custom plans that are available.